Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Gauss's law states that the electric flux through a closed surface equals the closed surface integral of the dot product of electric field and area dA, which equals the charge enclosed in the Gaussian surface divided by the permittivity of free space. Gauss's law for magnetism has to do with magnetic flux. Gauss's law for magnetism states that the magnetic flux through a closed surface equals the closed surface integral of the dot product of magnetic field and area dA, which equals, well, that's what we're going to figure out right now. To help us determine what magnetic flux through a closed surface equals, remind me, Billy, do magnetic monopoles exist? In other words, can you have a north magnetic pole without also having a south magnetic pole connected to it? Or a south magnetic pole without also having a north magnetic pole connected to it?
Okay, yeah. I remember this. A magnetic monopole has never been found in nature or in a man-made experiment, meaning we cannot prove magnetic monopoles do not exist. However, one has never been found, so at this point, we assume that magnetic monopoles do not exist. And someday, if we find a magnetic monopole, it will throw into question everything we use to describe how our universe works.
Nice.
Oh.
A bit dramatic, but yes, it is true that magnetic monopoles have never been found in nature. To recall what that means for magnetic fields, let's put an illustration of a magnetic field which surrounds a dipole magnet. Bo, remind me what the fact that magnetic monopoles have never been found in nature means for magnetic fields.
Sure. Because magnetic poles always come in pairs, magnetic field lines are always closed loops. And that means that inside the magnet, the magnetic field lines go from south to north to complete the closed loops.
Correct, Bo. Every magnetic field line is a closed loop. Most of the magnetic field line loops in this illustration actually reach beyond the area of this screen, but realize they are still loops, just very large loops. But let's return back to why we have this illustration on the screen. We are trying to determine what the magnetic flux through a closed surface equals. Bobby, what do you think?
Well, I guess we should draw a Gaussian surface and see what we see. Let's start with a sphere for a Gaussian surface.
Magnetic flux is the measure of the number of magnetic field lines which pass through a surface.
Yeah, right. You can see that every magnetic field line which goes into the Gaussian surface also comes out of the Gaussian surface. So the net magnetic flux through this Gaussian sphere equals zero.
Is that always true?
If you draw a randomly shaped Gaussian surface, even with part of the Gaussian surface inside the magnetic dipole, you can see that every magnetic field line which goes into the Gaussian surface also comes out of the Gaussian surface. So yeah, I would say because magnetic field lines are always closed loops, the magnetic flux through a closed surface always equals zero. Am I right, Mr. P?
Bo, that is absolutely correct. Thanks.
You are welcome.
Thank you for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.